What are your most favorable memories of your life?
It's gone. It's really gone.
For most people, having a child is one of the biggest events in their life. Do you remember the day Vivian was born?
No.
Do you remember the day that your son Roy, I was born?
No.
Would you like to say something on your birthday?
How old are you?
29.
Here we are again, birthday. 75 years.
Do you know what year it is?
Yeah, yes, 12,000, 13,000.
How old are you?
29.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming today and allowing my sister and our families a chance to celebrate our dad's life. Yesterday, I found a stack of some of my dad's old speeches. Boy, did he love giving speeches. One speech in particular was my dad's speech to me 39 years ago, where he told me to have dreams and aspirations, yet also to keep my feet on the ground. Good advice that my father too had followed throughout his life. Undoubtedly, my dad's most enduring qualities was his wonderful sense of humor and ability to maintain a sincere conversation with almost anyone. However, what was so fascinating about my dad was his ability to enjoy life and maintain a sunny disposition, even under the most adverse circumstances one could imagine. My dad was born in Hamburg, Germany, where his family were proud, affluent German Jews. At the age of 7, the Oppenheim family migrated from country to country, at times as refugees, in order to stay one step ahead of the Nazis. Soon after the war, Dad decided to seek his own fortune in the U.S. to pursue a career in the filmmaking business. He eventually secured a job in the film business, but instead of working himself up the ladder, he worked himself out the door. Nevertheless, my dad also got great solace from his cultural, religious, and political engagement, including helping establish a wonderful classical music program, where he ultimately became the guest conductor. For the last few years, my dad's memory and his ability to process became impaired. But I asked him about 2 years ago if it was frustrating to forget, and he told me no. I asked him why, and he told me it's not frustrating as he forgets what he forgot. So my dad. My dad never lost his charm nor his sense of humor. His happy disposition never faded. He was a true fighter, never complained about anything, and accepted his plight throughout life with remarkable good cheer. Like the advice he once gave me 35 years ago, my dad had no choice but to truly keep his feet to the ground as he pursued his dreams. Thank you.
We don't stop playing because we get old. We get old because we stop playing.
We're now being taped for the newspaper all over the world. Oh.
What are your biggest regrets in life?
I have no regrets. I should have gone to the hairdresser today. Yeah? What are you waiting for?
Does it bother you that you have lost these memories?
Yeah, very much so. I would have liked to have kept them more than I lost.
What's a final memory you want other people to remember you by?
My family.
Do you want people to remember you for family life, but you don't remember that family life? So how do you want people to remember you if you can't remember it? Or are there memories?
No.